Namaskar, I'm Ranjana Arora, heading Department of Curriculum Studies at NCERT. With me, there are two panelists. I would request them to introduce themselves.
Namaskar, I'm Manish Garg, Joint Secretary, School Education, Department of School Education and Literacy, MHRD. I am looking after the Samagra Shiksha Scheme, and I thank you for this opportunity.
Namaskar, I'm Dr. Sunita Chuk. I'm a faculty member at National Center for School Leadership, National Institute of Educational Planning and Administration.
Thank you. We all are here to discuss about a module, Initiatives in School Education under Samagra Shiksha. We have brought out this module for this Nishtha program, and we would like our teachers, our school heads to get awareness and information about various initiatives which MHRD has taken under Samagra Shiksha. So, to start with, I would like to ask a question to Manish ji, that why we have given this Samagra Shiksha title to this scheme?
Yeah, you see, this is a very good question. So, Samagra means holistic, and we aim at a holistic development of children. So, as you may be aware that earlier there were three centrally sponsored schemes. One was the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, which catered to classes 1 to 8. And then we had the Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, which catered primarily to the secondary level, classes 9 and 10. And then we had a centrally sponsored scheme for teacher education. So, these three schemes were being run by Government of India parallelly. And this actually effectively broke down the school education system into different silos, and due to which a lot of losses were there, a lot of transition losses were there between different levels. So, when the scheme was renewed in the year 2018-19, all the three schemes, these erstwhile schemes, they have been subsumed under the Samagra Shiksha, which has been launched from 2018-19. And this scheme now caters to all levels of school education, right from pre-primary to the senior secondary level. So, this is a first time that we are covering the senior secondary level as well as the preschool level under the school education program. And not only it subsumes the different levels, but various new elements have also been included under this program, which I believe that every teacher, every principal, every school head, and every educational functionary should be aware of that what are the new components of this Samagra Shiksha. And this is the reason why this module on Samagra Shiksha and the new initiatives under Samagra Shiksha has been included under this Nishtha Integrated Teachers Training program. And the different features of Samagra Shiksha as well as the new initiatives that have been taken are included under this module.
Thank you, Manishi. Really very nicely said that, yes, for the holistic development of children, it is needed that we see everything in school education in a holistic way. So, you have talked about new initiatives. I have heard that we are including youth club, eco club. So, sir, how do you think that these initiatives will help improving learning outcomes in children, and what will be the role of teacher into that?
Yes. the new initiative Samagra Shiksha is basically an umbrella scheme. So, besides the aspects such as the civil infrastructure, upgradation of schools up to senior secondary level to have composite schools, then it has components of the Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalayas. Yes. Then we have components which provide for various entitlements which are flowing from the Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Act, such as the free uniforms, free textbooks, transport facility. So these are available to each and every child, especially the textbooks are available to every child, and uniforms are also available as per the eligibility given under the scheme. So, these are available to every child in every government school. So, our teachers and the school heads, they are aware of these basic components. The funding amount also has been increased under this program. So besides, and of course we have also introduced the concept of the sports, regular sports grants to the schools, so that every year there is a renewal of the sports equipment and the sports facilities. Otherwise, normally it happens that once the sports equipment comes and then the next renewal takes after many years, due to which the children are not able to use those facilities actually. Sure. Similarly is the case for libraries. So under this scheme now we have made a provision that there will be a library grant which will be an annual basis, and for different levels of education the grant is different. So if the school is a composite, a large school, it will have a greater grant. So it gets a more grant if it is a composite school having a larger number of children, so that the libraries are also renewed on a regular basis and the libraries can actually be used by children. So purpose of library is not that the books will come and then they will be kept locked in the library room or in the principal's room. Purpose of having the library books or the library grant is that every child should have access to that library. So there should be a regular library period once a week for every child. Then the books should be regularly issued to the children. It's not as if the children don't get the book to read the books, or they don't get to carry back the books home. So they can even do the reading at home. So it has been seen that reading is one of the most important components of early learning, which really helps to increase the learning outcomes of the children. So that's why we are giving a lot of focus on the library component. Then from this year, you mentioned about the youth clubs and the eco clubs. So we see that the children in schools, they are actually not have the opportunity to undertake various social cultural activities, social activities the related to the environment or related to their community. So we have introduced the, and the paradox is that the school premises are available after school hours, but there is no one there to actually make them accessible to the children. Mm-hmm. Of the same school. So after the school hours, the school gates get locked and the children are not able to use those facilities.
Yes.
So we thought that, the ministry thought that we should have a concept like a youth club and an eco club, so that the children can get organized and they can use the school facilities even after school hours, so that they can have a holistic personality development. They can engage in various activities related to arts and culture, related to sports, related to community service or other community mobilization related activities, or environmental related activities. So the what has been envisaged under the youth and eco club is that there will be one teacher will be made in charge of that youth club, and the overall, of course, responsibility remains with the school head, but for the routine functioning there will be one teacher in charge, and who will provide access to these facilities to the students in the after school hours. So this teacher in charge can be on a rotational basis, so that the same teacher doesn't have to stay back every throughout the year. So it can be on a rotational basis, and of course the eco club can help inculcate the values related to environmental protection, ecology, cleanliness, sanitation, all those things will come under the, of course, water conservation is a major campaign now under the Jal Shakti. So all, they will be involved in all these kind of activities. So that is the purpose of the youth and eco club.
This is really
wonderful.
I think a great initiative, because I think with this we will learn how to optimize resources.
Yes,
even
there,
even this after school hours.
Yeah.
So that's really nice. Now I would like to ask Professor Sunita Chukji, now teachers have really a great role to play in this, but how do you visualize school heads to implement these kinds of initiatives in the school, the way they these need to be implemented with that spirit? So
yes, Ranjana ji, in fact, I would agree with Manish sir that they have really taken a very encouraging step. where they are, you know, integrating different schemes and they are bringing it to one platform. So similarly, this Nishtha program is bringing the school heads and the teachers on the common platform so that they can share their experiences and they can have, you know, the how to implement this. So for the school heads and the system level functionaries, they need to this through this program, and when they come together, the school heads and the system level functionaries need to internalize, you know, the whole of the components of the scheme, and they need to take initiative in the implementation. In fact, you know, ultimate aim, as you know, Manishji has also said, that may it be, you know, creating the infrastructure, may it be, you know, creating the other kind of a co-curricular activities and using the infrastructure in a more constructive way. So ultimate aim is that, you know, we need to improve the learning outcomes of the children. And they, school heads have a very important role. They have a, in fact, a pivotal role, as to they need to provide support and facilitate the teachers. If they want to take any kind of a initiative, they need to provide the support so that, you know, all the components which has been visualized under this scheme, they get implemented. And we, in fact, you know, in the implementation, this school leadership, you know, we have developed at NCSL the whole of the package, which talks about how the different components and the how different modules, when they are also being, you know, the school heads and the other system level functionaries also being oriented to different modules under this package. And we have developed a school leadership module, which, you know, talk about how, what kind of a leadership the leaders need to have a knowledge, what kind of a skills they need to be made, and what kind of a competencies need to be built of the school heads, so they can they implement this particular scheme. And in this module and in this package, we really give a, you know, roadmap for the implementation of this particular scheme, and so that teachers and the school heads come together and make it is a success.
So it's good that now teacher and principals will be at the same platform. Yeah. So I think then implementation really will happen the way we want these things to be implemented. In this Samagra Shiksha module, we are also talking about school safety and also self-defense. Mm-hmm. So, would you like to throw light on that?
Yeah, of course. That is a very important aspect which everyone associated with the schooling system should be sensitized towards.
Yes.
School safety is a very important issue, especially in today's scenario, where the incidents of violence or the stress, yes, because of the increased stress levels. So that is, we see increasing among the children, increasing among the youth, increasing among the teachers. So we have to make the teachers sensitive about these issues. So under the Samagra Shiksha scheme also, we have this year introduced one component which encourages the teachers themselves to act as a first level counselor.
Yes.
Now when a child is in a school, so his first point, his or her first point of contact is the teacher only.
Yes.
So if the teacher can understand what the child is feeling, what the how the emotions of the child are evolving, or how, if there are any psychological problems or emotional problems the child is facing, so the teacher is the first person who can identify this, and not only identify but can take some identify what is the reason for that problem, because children don't open up in front of parents or at home, but in front of teachers when properly guided, so they can come out with their problems, their issues, their challenges, and the teacher can counsel them, guide them on how to address those challenges. So as part of the Nishtha program, we hope that we can encourage and develop every teacher as a first level counselor, so that they are aware of these issues. Secondly is the issue of the safety of children.
Yes.
So safety and security of children is both in terms of the physical safety. So the school principal should be aware that what are the physical aspects of safety in his or her school. Do some kind of a safety walk around the school, a safety audit of the school, so that the physical infrastructure point of view and the, from the access point of view, the school is safe. Second comes the aspect of softer aspects of safety, which deals with interaction of children with each other and interaction of children with the teachers themselves. So the teachers have to be sensitive and the principals have to be sensitive about the safety aspects. Besides that, we are also providing self-defense training to the girl students especially. And under Samagra Shiksha now, this training has been extended to girls from classes 6 to 12. And this year also we have provided funding to nearly 2,10,000 schools roughly, which have girl students for self-defense training. So we are focusing more on the practical aspects of self-defense training also. It is not like they are training in only a particular martial art or a particular
judo, karate.
So all those things are components, but looking at more of a holistic aspect of a self-defense, like how to use the circumstances to defend themselves, how to use the material available around them, the props available around them to actually feel safe or be safe, and to develop a kind of a confidence amongst girls. And we believe that this self-defense training develops that kind of confidence, which prompts the girls to come regularly to schools. Okay. Because so that they can travel independently and they can come to the school on a regular basis. So hopefully it has an impact on the attendance, regular attendance of girls in schools also. So self-defense training is an important aspect. So I will request the school heads to actually to confirm whether they have been approved self-defense training in the current year. And based on that, they can nearly every school which is having girl students of classes 6 to 12 will have access to some kind of self-defense training. And of course, it can be implemented in convergence with the police department, with the civil defense, home guards department as well, so that the trainers can come from there also. So that will be one aspect that is a very important component of the overall school safety.
Maybe these, you know, initiatives will bring, you know, more confidence among the parents as well to send them, you know. So this will
This is very important, because once I was in a rural school, and their teachers were saying that because of the self-defense, enrollment of girls has been increased like anything in that school. So this self-defense is really a very good initiative. We found this module actually also covers this PGI. So we also, and you Dice Plus, so we don't like, we want to have little brief understanding of these two concepts also. So
a PGI stands for the Performance Grading Index.
Yes.
And it is a 70 indicator index that has been evolved by the ministry, by the Department of School Education. The objective of this is that assess where the different states are, and provide inputs to the states on what are the aspects they need to work upon to actually make improvements in their overall learning outcomes and the school system. So this is focuses not only on the as is situation, like what is the at present availability of infrastructure, at present enrollment, at present achievement, learning achievements, but it also focuses more importantly on the governance aspects. And nearly out of 1000 point index, 360 points are for the domain of the governance reforms only.
Okay.
So this PGI is actually encouraging the states to undertake various governance reforms in the field of school education. And then of course there is a grading aspect. The schools are getting a grading, and gradually the PGI is also being expanded to the district level. So we will know as to actually how what a good district school system should look like, what should it be, what it are its components, and what can be done to improve the grading of the particular district or the particular state. So
these initiatives also merge or converge in those kinds of gradings?
Yes, of course.
Of course, it is various
initiatives such as whether there is a separate cadre for the school headmasters, or there is some kind of a direct recruitment component is there. It may be a limited direct recruitment.
Yes.
Then whether there is some way of electronically capturing the attendance of the students and the teachers. Then of course whether the fund flow is regular from the state level to the
district
level, so that fund flow is very important. So, and many other components are there which actually help to improve the school functioning of the school system.
And UDICE Plus, what kind of data now it started capturing?
UDICE Plus is a platform that has been launched by the ministry along with the NIC, in which we are capturing all data related to the school, the student, and the teacher. And it is meant to be an online package which can be regularly updated. So we get a clear picture of what the school system, status of the school system is at present. And each school has also been linked to a GIS through the GIS coordinates to a GIS mapping so that we can see the position of the school, and any policy decision related to the school can be taken based on the GIS coordinates and the availability of the various resources, a school report card kind of a thing that is generated out of the data that is captured from the school. So,
is it a live data?
Yes, it is going to be a live data. So, we are presently capturing the information from the all the schools. And most of it has come for the current year. And gradually it will be made a more real time and online updation.
So I think even school principals can utilize help of this data.
Yes. Of course, that is another aspect of UDICE Plus, that earlier we used to collect data and then it used to remain somewhere. But the states or the districts or the schools could not utilize it. Now this data will be available to because it has come from them only actually. But they are not able to see it or utilize it. So, under the UDICE Plus, they will also be able to see, visualize the data, analyze and utilize the data.
So, this will be useful for the informed decision making.
Yes.
You know?
So, under Samagra Shiksha, we are also providing a composite school grant to every school. So, this composite school grant earlier used to be a fixed amount, whatever be the enrollment of the school. So, even a school with an enrollment of 1000 will get the same grant as a school with an enrollment of 30. So that was the earlier parameter. But under Samagra Shiksha, and this is very important for the school heads, under Samagra Shiksha, we are giving a grant which is based on the enrollment of children in the schools. So if the enrollment crosses a certain threshold, the school grant becomes 1 lakh and starting from 25,000. If the enrollment is between 30 and 100 students, it is 25,000. If it is between 100 and 250, then it is 50,000 and 75,000 and then 1 lakh.
Very important.
So, this composite school grant is very useful for the regular maintenance of the various facilities in the school, provision of the basic components in the school, like even sometimes the electricity bills are paid out of the composite school grant. And even some laboratory reagents or so those things can come under the composite school grant, and of course the normal routine maintenance of the school building. Another important component of the composite school grant is the Swachhta grant.
Very important.
At least we are saying under Samagra Shiksha, at least 10% of the composite school grant is to be used for Swachhta related activities. Whether it is maintenance of the toilets, the regular cleanliness, repair, maintenance. So, and of course the maintenance and cleanliness of the school premises. So, all those components are covered under the Swachhta grant, which is a part of the composite school grant. So, this composite school grant can be very effectively utilized by the school heads and the teachers. To actually build a very very friendly, child-friendly kind of a school environment. And of course, you can also dovetail, and you can also motivate the community to
participate
and contribute in different manners. Many states have experimented that, like Rajasthan, Maharashtra. So they have Tamil Nadu. They have encouraged a lot of community participation. They are getting a lot of funds and participation from the community, which also helps to build a very child-friendly and good healthy school environment.
It gives them some kind of ownership also.
It gives them an ownership, and they can also contribute.
So thank you very much, Manishji, Sunita ji. So now we are concluding this session. Of course, we have really got very good information and very important information about various initiatives taken by the MHRD under Samagra Shiksha, as well as on other aspects. We hope that with this session, our school heads and our teachers will be able to see these initiatives very helpful, not only for improving the whole school environment, but also improving the learning outcomes of children, because I found that many initiatives are related to experiential learning, like youth club and eco club. So we can provide lots of experience to children implementing these kinds of initiatives. So thanks once again to Manishji and Sunita ji. Be with us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.